Hello and welcome to Java Deepmind. And today the topic of discussion is stack in data structure, and we'll study the C program to implement stack and what is we are going to use is using array. So using array we are going to implement stack. Okay, fine. And we'll use which language? C language. So I'm going to show you the program how we are creating a stack using array with C language. Let's start. Okay, so I'll show you the step. So this page is divided into two parts. So I'm dividing the page into two parts. Fine. So first of all, I have created a menu. Menu means what? That is, according to menu, you will ask the user to do. Either he want to push element, either he want to pop an element, either he want to print element, or he want to exit. Fine. Okay. So let's start with the first line. Hash define max 3. This is what? This is a macro. This is a macro, and with macro we have made a macro called max, and the value of max is 3. So the max value is 3. Fine. Okay, so this is defined value. That value of max is 3. We have created a function push, we have created a function pop, and we have created a function print. So these are what? These are what? Declaration or prototype. These are prototype. Fine. Okay, I'll explain you each and every line. Here what I'm doing, here I'm creating an array of size max. The value of max is what? 3. So that is, I'm creating an array, and I'm creating a vertical array. Why a vertical array? Because stack looks a vertical. So either it's not a issue that I can create it horizontal also. So, but it looks nice if I'm creating a vertical. Okay. So st max, that value of max is 3. So I'm creating an array of size 3. That is 0, 1, and 2, and the name of this array is st. Fine. I'm also creating a variable top. The value of top is minus 1. So I'm creating a variable top, and obviously this top is value minus 1. Why? Because there is no element in the stack. So the current value of top will be minus 1. Fine. Okay. Now what am I doing is that these are all global variables. These are all global variables. Now I'm creating a main function, and in main function I've created a local variable ch. I've cleared a screen. If you are using Turbo C++, you can use clear screen. If you are not using, do not use clear screen. Fine. While one. What is while one? While, and what is one? One is means condition is always true. So while one means condition always true. Condition always true. Fine. So it will move inside, and it will print 4 lines. 1 push, 2 pop, 3 print, and 4 exist. Is it similar like a menu of a restaurant? Whenever you go to a restaurant and you ask for something, for a menu, you always watch, or you always see a menu is having some numbers, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 5. 1 is for popcorn, 2 is for sandwiches, and 3 is for pizza, and 4 is for pasta, and everything like that. And you just order, give me order for me the point number 1 or 2, or whatever you feel like. Okay, so you are having 4 options. That is 1 for push, 2 for pop, 3 for print, and 4 for exit. So these are first part of my code, and now I move to the second part. So now you have a menu, and waiter is standing in front of you, and he's asking, sir, what is your choice? Enter the choice. So one printf is asking for a choice. You have a menu where you have a 4 options, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and in which what you want. I said I want push. First of all, I want to push. So what I said, what I pressed, I pressed 1. The moment I pressed 1, scanf scanned what? 1. Ch has value 1. Switch will have value 1. So the moment switch will have value 1, so what is switch? Switch pass jumps to the same case to the value it is having. It is having value 1, it will jump to the case 1, and case 1 we are calling a function push. The moment I am calling a function push, it will jump to the definition of push. So let's start with definition of push. Here I am calling a function push. So what will happen? I will jump to the definition of push. Let's push. Let's jump to the definition of push. Okay, fine. So I came to the push function. Okay, fine. And here I've created a local variable item. So one box is created, and the box name is item. This variable is created. Clear screen. Is top is equal to max minus 1? Let's make a array. Let's make a stack first. So stack was 0, 1, 2. This was st stack, and the current value of top was what? Minus 1, which I have already told you. Just see this. The top value was minus 1. Fine. Okay. Now what is checking is that, is top is equal to max minus 1? What was the value of max? 3. 3 minus 1 is what? 2. Is minus 1 equal to 2? No, minus 1 is not equal to 2. This is false. The moment it gets false, so obviously it's not overflow condition. It will come to the else part. It will increase top to top plus 1. That is what I told you. In the moment you want to push, you first increase the top. So top is equal to top plus 1. The current value of top is minus 1 and plus 1 will make it 0. So top will point to 0th position, top. And then what I'll do, I'll ask the user to enter the item to insert. I have asked, the user entered 5. So what will happen? This item variable will have value 5. So this item variable will now have a value 5. And what am I doing is that ST, that is ST, top is what? 0. ST 0 will have item. And what is there in item? 5. So ST 0 will have item what? 5. Hope you understood. Fine. Okay. So now stack has one element and top is pointing to the 0th position. Fine. It will come out of the else box. The moment it will come out of the push function, what will happen? Now understand. The moment I come out of the push function, this item variable which was local will get vanished. Why? Because item is a local variable and the life of local variable is till the control remain in the block. And for this you need to study the storage class. The item variable will get removed. Now you must be thinking, why not ST? Why not top? If I show you this ST, this top, all are global variables and the life of global variable is till the program comes to an end. Right now I'm not out of the program. The moment I'm not out of the program, this variable will remain same. Fine. Okay. The top will have value 0 and ST 0th position will have value 5. Okay. Now when you come out of this push function, where you will go? You will go from where you have received the call. Where you have received the call? You have received the call from this place. And it will move to the next line. What is next line? Break. What break will do? Break will take you out from switch. You will come out of switch. This bracket is for switch, as WIC. This bracket is for while. And this bracket is for main. Fine. This bracket is for main function. You have created three brackets. 1, 2, and 3. So these are three closing bracket. The moment you get a statement break, it will come out of switch. Then it will try to come out from while, but while will not let it to come out because while will ask to go and check the condition first. The moment I'll go and check the condition is again 1, and 1 is what? True. The condition is again true. So what will I'll again got trapped in this loop, and this loop is again giving me an option 1 for push, 2 for pop, 3 for print and 4 for exit. In a similar fashion, the moment you had the one of the menu, the waiter again comes to you and asks, sir, what do you want next? So now you again said, enter the choice. Waiter is asking to enter the choice. You said 1. Again, you pressed 1. CH is having a value 1. Switch is having 1. Again, it will move to the case 1. And case 1 is calling push. It will go to the push function. Fine. Okay. It will again come. It will create an item variable again. Why again? Because item is a local variable. So it will create an item variable again. Okay. It will again check. Is top is equal to max minus 1? Now current value of top is 0 and max minus 1 is 2. No, 0 is not equal to 2. Condition again becomes false. It will come here. Top is equal to top plus 1. So top 0 plus 1 is what? Top. Top will come to the next empty position. I'll ask, enter the item to insert. Suppose I want to insert 8. So item will have 8. And at last what I'm doing? ST top. Top value is 1. ST 1 will have item. So ST 1 will have item. And what is there in item 8? Fine. So 8 will be here. Fine. Okay. Now what will happen? The moment I'll come out of the else, I'll come out. The moment I come out of the push function, this item variable will get deleted because its life is finished now. Where it will go? It will go to the function where it has received the call. It has received the call from push. Fine. It again see the break. It come out of the switch. Again, it will come try to come out of the while. But while will ask him to go and check the condition. Condition is again 1. Again, 4 menu will be popped. And it will ask you again, what is your choice? Again, I have pressed 1. Again, switch 1. Again, case 1. Again, push. Again, I'll come to the push. Again, I'll create an item. Fine. Again, I'll create an item. I'll move very fast now. Is top is equal to max minus 1? Top is what? 1. And what is max? 2. No, top 1 is not equal to 2. I'll again increase the top. Top is equal to top plus 1. Top will come here. Fine. Okay. I'll again ask, enter the element to insert. I have inserted 9. So item will have 9. And what I'll do, ST top. Top value is 2. ST 2 will have item. So what is there in item? 9. So 9 will come here. The moment I come out of else, I'll come out. The moment I come out of push, this item will get deleted. This will be because it's a local variable. Where I'll go to the function where I receive a call. I have received a call from this. Again, the next line is break. I'll come out of the switch. Again is while. While will not let me to go out. I'll go to the while condition. Again, condition true. Again, I'll see the 3, 4 print statement, 4 menu statement. Again, somebody is asking me enter the choice. Again, I have pressed 1. Switch is again having 1. Case 1. Again, push function will be called. I'll come to the push now again. I'll create an item now again. I'll create an item again. Is top is equal to max minus 1? Yes. Now current value of top is 2 and max minus 1 is 2 and in front of you stack is full. So what I'll print overflow. See the condition. Now you are printing an overflow. Now you will not be able to insert an element. Fine. Okay. So now you, so condition is, now this condition becomes true. Now this condition becomes true and you will print an overflow. That the moment you try to print after, put after third element, you will not be able to find. So what will happen? You will not go to the else part because if has been executed, you come out of the push where you will go push statement break. You come out of the break, you come out of the switch. While will not let you to come out. Again, you go and check the condition. Condition is true. Again, you will see 4 options. Now what you pressed 3. Now what you pressed 3. The moment you pressed 3, CH is having what? 3. Switch is having 3. The switch will take you the case 3, and in case 3 we are calling a pre function, that is print function. Fine. Now we are calling which function? Print function. Fine. So I'm calling a print function. So what? Now you see the current situation is 5, 8. Current situation of after pushing an element of in stack was 5, 8, 9. So I'm calling a print function. So here I'm calling a print. It will jump to the print definition. Here print a definition, and the current situation of stack was 5, 8, 9. So I'm making a condition stack 5, 8 and 9, 0, 1 and 2, and top is pointing to second position. Fine. Okay, it's checking. Is top is equal to minus 1? No, the value of top is 2. It's not equal to minus 1. Condition become false. I come out. I come to the else part. For I is equal to top. What is top? 2. So for I is equal to 2. Yes, is 2 greater than 0? Yes, condition true. What I'll do, I'll print st 2. What is there in st 2? 9. So I'll print 9 over here, where in mid of double quotes. So I've created specially I've created this double quotes, and in mid of double quote, what you are printing? %d, or what is %d? st 2. What is there in st 2? 9. And after 9, where what is there? New line. So it will come to the new line. Again, it will jump and it will decrease the value of I from 2 to 1. So the current value of I will become 1. Okay, fine. Is 1 greater than 0? Yes. So it will print st1. St1 is 8. So it will print like this. So you will feel you will have a feel of stack. It will print 9 and then 8. Okay, after printing, what will do? It will come to the new line. It will come to the new line. Fine. Okay, it will come to the new line. It will again decrement the value of I. I'll become 0. Is 0 greater than 0? No, but it's equal to 0. Condition again become true. It will print st0. What is st0? 5. So it will print 5 like this. What will happen? It will again decrement I. I'll become minus 1. Is minus 1 greater than 0? No, it becomes false. The moment it becomes false, you come out of the else part, or you come out of the loop, you come out of the else part, you come out of the function, and here is the output. The value in stack are 5, 8 and 9, and 9 is the top element. So here is the best way how you can print element into the stack, element of the stack. So what happens now? The moment you come out of the print function, where you will go? You will again go to the place where you have received the call. You have received the call from this place, and the next line is break. Break means you come out of the switch. While will not let you to come out. So what while will do? While say check the condition, but after checking the condition, I found condition is true. So again, I'm getting a 4 option: 1 for push, 2 for pop, 3 for print, 4 for exit. And now what I did, I have pressed 2. So now CH is having 2, switch is having 2, and CH will take me to case 2, and in case 2 I'm calling which function? Pop function. So I'm now going to show you the working of pop function. So I'll move to the pop function, and the current situation of stack is 5, 8, 9. So I'm going to make this 5, 8, 9 over here. Fine. So I'm going to make this 5, 8 and 9, that is 0, 1, and 2, and top is pointing to the second position. Fine, okay. Again, what I'll do, I'll make a variable item. Okay, this item is a local variable. I have created this local variable. I've cleared the screen. Again, I'll say if you're using Turbo C, then use clear screen. If you are using closed code blocks, then do not use this clear screen function. Is top is equal to minus 1? No, top is not minus 1. Top is equal to 2. So this is false. I'll come to the else part. What I'm doing, item is having st2. What is there in this array is st. st2 is having value 9. So this item will have 9. Fine. What I'll do, I'll print deleted element is %d. So this statement will get printed. Deleted element is equal to %d, and in %d, what will be printed? Item. Item is having 9. So I'll see that item deleted is 9. It will be printed. That is, this element is deleted. Automatically, it's not get deleted, but we'll see that it's deleted. And top will decrease. Top minus minus. So top will come to this place. Top minus minus. Fine. Okay. So what happens? You come out of the else. Fine, you come out of the pop. The moment you come out of the function, what happened? This item variable will vanish. This life is finished now. Where you will go? From where you have received the call. You have received the call from which place? You have received the call from pop. Again, the next line is what? Break. Break will come out, will make you out of switch. This while will not let you out. Again, you will set 4 options. Again, you pressed 2. Switch will take to the second case. Second case is pop. Now I will not come to this place again. Okay, I've tried to make you explain every time, so I'll do everything over there only. Okay, so is top is equal to minus 1? No. Again, item will be created. Again, this item will be created. Fine. Okay. Is top is equal to minus 1? No, top is not minus 1 because top is 1. So I'll come to the else part. Item will have st. Top value is 1. st1 is having 8. So 8 will come here. So printed line will be deleted element is 8 because item is having 8. Top minus minus, this 8 will get deleted, and top minus minus will let you here. Again, you come out of this, you go there in main function, you again pressed 2, you again come to the pop function, you again created a variable item. Again, you check top is equal to minus 1. No, top is 0 and 0 is not equal to minus 1. Condition false. You, what you do, item has st0. Why 0? Top value 0. st0 is having 5. So item is having value 5. Again, deleted element is what? 5. So it will bring deleted element is 5. Again, top minus minus, top current value 0, and 0 minus minus will make you make top is equal to what? Minus 1. Again, you go to the main function, you come out of the switch, you again go to the while, again you pressed 2, again you come to the pop, again you created this item variable. Again, you check, is top is equal to minus 1? Yes, now top is minus 1. Condition become true, and in front of you, stack is empty. Now you will not be able to pop anything. So what will get printed? Underflow. Fine. So I've tried my level best to explain you this code. So I request you to kindly run the same code. You will be able to see the running of this code very easily. Fine. So at last, what I'll say thank you so much for watching Java Deep Point. Please like, subscribe, and share the channel. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.